Have you ever wanted to make your own screaming police siren? One that you can dial up, slow down, or make warble like a movie prop? Hey guys, in this video you'll learn how to make an adjustable police siren using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 555 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. Two alligator clips, a 100 kilo potentiometer, a 50 kilo potentiometer, 20 jumper wires, a 100 kilo ohm resistor, a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor, 110 kilo ohm resistor, 110 microfarad capacitor, 10.1 microfarad capacitor, 147 microfarad capacitor, 110 nanofarad ceramic capacitor, a 9-volt battery buckle connector, a 9-volt battery, a 5-watt speaker, two 555 timer ICs, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. I need to connect this 100 kilo potentiometer to the 555 timer. Basically, the goal is to link the potentiometer directly to the 555 so it can control the circuit's frequency and adjust the siren's pitch. Insert a jumper wire from pin 7 or discharge and a few rows above the 555. Place another jumper wire into the same row as the one you just connected, right in the center area of the breadboard. Insert a jumper wire into pin 2 or trigger in a few rows above the 555. Bend the ends of a 100 kilo ohm resistor. Insert a 100 kilo ohm resistor into pin 8 or VCC in a few rows above the 555. Place the 100 kilo potentiometer onto the breadboard, ensuring each of its three terminals aligns with the three separate rows where you previously inserted the wires. Here is a side view. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor in pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. The anode is in pin 2. Insert a 10 nanofarad ceramic capacitor into pin 5 or control in the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the capacitor in the negative rail. Insert a 555 timer a few rows below the jumper wire. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 10 kilo ohm resistor. Insert a 10 kilo ohm resistor into pin 8 or VCC and a few rows below the second 555. Insert a jumper wire into pin 2 or trigger in a few rows below the 555. Insert a jumper wire from pin 7 or discharge in a few rows below the 555. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the previous jumper wire. Similar to the previous potentiometer, connect this 50 kilo potentiometer to the second 555. Insert a 0.1 microfarad capacitor in pin 2, or trigger and the negative rail. The anode is in pin 2. Insert a 47 microfarad capacitor in pin 3 or output, and a row below the 555. The anode is in pin 3. Bend the ends of a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor. Insert a 4.7 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3 of the first 555 and pin 5 of the second 555. Insert a jumper wire in the same row as the capacitor. Connect the other end of the jumper wire to an alligator clip. Insert a jumper wire in the negative rail. Connect the other end of the jumper wire to an alligator clip. Connect the alligator clips to a 5-watt speaker. Connect the 9-volt battery buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Insert the positive lead to the positive rail. Insert the negative lead to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Rotate the potentiometer knobs to change the circuit's frequency, which lets you raise or lower the siren's pitch to your liking. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This circuit is a two-stage 555 timer police siren powered from a 9-volt battery. Both 555 timer ICs share the same rails, with pin 8 tied to the 9-volt battery, pin 1 to ground, and pin 4 held high so the timers are always enabled. The first 555 on the left is configured as a low-frequency Astable oscillator that generates a slow modulation signal. The second 555 on the right is configured as a higher frequency Astable oscillator that produces the audible tone and drives the speaker. By using one timer to modulate the other, the circuit creates the classic rising and falling siren sound. In the first 555, the timing network is formed by the 100 kilo ohm potentiometer, the 1 kilo ohm resistor, and the 10 nanofarad capacitor connected between pin 2 and pin 6 in ground. In a stable mode, the capacitor repeatedly charges and discharges between 1/3 and 2/3 of the supply voltage. During charging through the resistors, the output at pin 3 stays high. Once the capacitor reaches 2/3 VCC, the internal discharge transistor turns on, the capacitor discharges, and when it falls below 1/3 VCC, the output flips low to high again. This continuous cycle produces a slow square wave at pin 3. Adjusting the 100 kilo ohm pot changes the charge and discharge times, letting you control how fast the siren sweep occurs. The 10 nanofarad capacitor from pin 5 of this first 555 to ground stabilizes its internal reference voltages and helps keep the timing stable and less sensitive to noise. The second 555 generates the actual siren tone. Its timing components are the 50 kilo ohm potentiometer and 10 kilo ohm resistor feeding pin 7 from the 9 volt battery, together with the 100 nanofarad capacitor from pin 2 and pin 6 to ground. This combination makes it oscillate at a much higher frequency, well within the audio range, so the output at pin 3 is heard as a steady tone when left unmodulated. As with any Astable 555, the capacitor charges through the resistors until 2/3 VCC, then discharges until 1/3 VCC, with the output toggling each time. The 50 kilo ohm pot lets you set the bass pitch of the siren from deeper to sharper tones. The characteristic police siren effect comes from the 4.7 kilo ohm resistor, connecting the output of the first 555 on pin 3 to the second 555 on pin 5. Pin 5 sets the internal reference levels for the second timer's thresholds, so when the slow square wave from the first 555 is fed into this pin through the 4.7 kilo ohm resistor, it gently shifts those internal levels up and down. As these reference points move, the effective charge and discharge thresholds of the 100 nanofarad timing capacitor change, causing the oscillation frequency of the second 555 to rise and fall. Instead of a fixed tone, the pitch now continuously sweeps in sync with the low frequency waveform from the first 555, creating the familiar wee-woo siren sound. The first potentiometer controls how fast this sweep happens, while the second potentiometer sets the bass pitch and the overall range of the siren. The output of the second 555 at pin 3 is coupled to the speaker through the 47 nanofarad capacitor. This capacitor blocks DC, so the speaker only receives the alternating audio signal, protecting the voice coil from unnecessary DC current while allowing the full modulated tone to pass. With the speaker's other terminal connected to ground, the modulated output from the second 555 drives it directly, producing a strong, adjustable police siren using just these two interconnected 555 timers. I hope this video has shown you how to make an adjustable police siren with 555 timer ICs. Want to dive deeper into 555 timer projects? Grab my free ebook packed with awesome circuits and ideas. Just click the link in the description to download your copy now. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.